Welcome back to my Final Cut Pro 10 tutorial series. In this part of the series, I'm going to show you how to time your primary storyline and add some layers above it. I'll add some cutaways above my primary storyline to make it more visually exciting. This is part 4 of the series. If you haven't seen parts 1 through 3, I'd suggest going back and watching them. I've made a playlist I'll link up top and in the description. I'll also add links to individual videos in my description. If you enjoy my videos, don't be afraid to hit the like button below and subscribe to my channel. Also, if there's a particular topic you'd like to see explained in my future videos, leave me a suggestion in the comments below. In my last video, I created a rough cut of my primary storyline. All my clips I selected added up to about 4 minutes. I'd like a video a little longer than that, around 6 minutes. I can add more clips to the end, or ripple trim and make my existing clips longer. I can also add gaps in between my clips. This works especially well if your primary storyline is interview soundbite driven. You can add gaps between sound bites to make speech sound more natural. To insert a gap in between clips, first position the playhead where you want to insert your gap clip. Then, click Edit, Insert Generator, and Gap. A default 3-second gap clip is inserted in between your clips. Another way to insert a gap clip is to use the keyboard shortcut Option W. You can ripple trim the length of the gap clips to whatever you like. When you play back your timeline, the gap clip will be a blank screen with no sound or video. Next, I want to talk about Final Cut Pro's Blade Tool. The Blade Tool allows you to break a clip into smaller sections to be moved elsewhere or completely removed from your timeline. To use the Blade Tool, either select it from the Tools pop-up menu or use keyboard shortcut B. The pointer changes to an image of a razor blade. Skim and click wherever you want to blade your clip. Press A to go back to the Select tool. Your clip is now divided into two separate clips that can be moved or deleted. You can also choose the Blade tool while still using the Select tool with a keyboard shortcut. Skim over to where you want to blade your clip, and instead of selecting the Blade tool, press Command B. Your clip is bladed into two sections. Let's skim ahead a couple seconds and use Command B to blade the clip again. Select the middle portion and press Delete to remove it from your timeline. Skim back before your cut and press Spacebar to play this clip. When you jump in time like that, it's called a jump cut. Jump cuts are unpleasant to the viewer and you generally want to avoid them. But there's a few tricks you can use to hide jump cuts that I'll go over in one of my future videos. I'm going to use Command Z keyboard shortcut to undo that. If you want to delete a clip, but not change the timing of your storyline, you can delete a clip and replace it with a gap clip. Select the clip you want to delete and press Shift Delete. The clip is deleted and replaced with a gap clip of the same duration. When you blade a clip without removing any parts of it, it's called a through edit, and it's represented by a dashed line. If you change your mind or make a mistake, you can easily repair it by joining a through edit. Press A on your keyboard to make sure you're using the Select tool, and click the dashed line in your clip. Only one side of the through edit is selected. Now, press Delete. The through edit point is removed, and the two segments are rejoined into a clip. I'm going to go through my project and add some gap clips to time my storyline. After you build and time your primary storyline, it's time to add some additional footage to your video. If you have a soundbite-based storyline, you can add some B-roll footage to see what the soundbites are discussing. In a video like mine, you can add some different angles to make video more interesting, cover the gap clips, and hide some jump cuts I talked about earlier. Instead of inserting clips into a primary storyline and messing up the timing, you can layer your clips above your storyline. As far as video goes, your top layer will always be what's visible on screen. Audio will be mixed from all your layers. To add a clip above your storyline, press A for Select tool and position your playhead where you want to add your clip. Use the I and O keys to select part of the clip you want to connect and use the Connect Edit button. The clip is layered over your primary storyline. Skim back to before the edit and use Spacebar to review your clip. You can ripple trim your clip as necessary. Let's place a playhead before the clip ends and connect another clip. Pick the clip you want to connect and use the keyboard shortcut Q. Another layer is created on top of your storyline because your clips overlap. Just like I mentioned before, the top layer will always be visible on screen. You can ripple trim your second layer back, and when they don't overlap, the third layer will drop down. Each clip above the primary storyline has a connection point that synchronizes it to the primary storyline. If you move a clip in your primary storyline, the connected clips goes with it. You can override this behavior by holding down the grave accent key. This tells Final Cut Pro to ignore the connection point and leave the connected clip where it is. I'm going to add some different angle clips to my storyline and trim them until I'm happy with how it looks. B-roll clips above your storyline take over the storytelling of the project. Sometimes you may want to ripple trim or move your connected clips. Because each connected clip is independent, moving or trimming one clip does not affect the clips beside it like in the primary storyline. If you like the relationship between your connected clips and do not want to alter it, you can create a connected storyline. Click on the first clip and shift-click on your last one to select all your clips. Now, right-click on any of the selected clips and choose Create Storyline. A gray bar appears above your clips. Instead of having three connection points like before, now there's only one. The clips in the created storyline will now behave like clips in the primary storyline. If one clip is deleted, the other clips snap together. Ripple trimming one clip will now move your other clips over. Select the gray bar above your connected storyline, and you can append, edit, or insert edit clips to it just like in the primary storyline. You can also move all the clips in the created storyline by clicking the gray bar above it and dragging it. I'm going to go through my clips and add in some secondary storyline footage to make my video more visually interesting. In my next video, I'm going to add some clips below my primary storyline. I'll add in some background music and sound effects. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss it. Ask any questions you may have in the comments, and I'll do my best to answer them. Once again, thanks for watching, and I hope you come back for more.